My name is Fatima Hussein. I'm a professor in the Department of Speech and Hearing Science and also a part-time faculty member here at Beckman Institute. A major focus of my lab is studying tinnitus and hearing loss. Hearing loss is easier to understand, right? You can't hear very well, so everybody knows what it is. Tinnitus is sometimes difficult to understand if you don't know anybody who has it. Tinnitus is the perception of sound when there is no source, but you're hearing this constant sound, often called ringing in the ears. But it doesn't have to be ringing. It can be all sorts of sounds. It can be very tonal. It can be like cicadas. It can be whooshing, a waterfall. And as one patient told me, it can be like a freight train through your head. The great, great majority of the cases are actually constant chronic tinnitus, which means you're hearing it all the time unless you're sleeping or you're very distracted by something else. It does have a psychological impact on you. Some people are very used to it, but for others, it interferes with their sleep, it interferes with the ability to concentrate, it may cause depression and anxiety, it may interfere with even communication. We call this bothersome or severe tinnitus. So we study these individuals because they need the most help, because it is a very subjective disorder. We have become more innovative in how we approach tinnitus. Brain imaging is an excellent tool to peer inside the brain as someone is hearing the sound and the impact on them. So this is the first study of its kind with tinnitus and arterial spin labeling, and what it does is allows us to measure perfusion or blood flow in the brain using MRI. ASL or arterial spin labeling gives us an estimate of absolute numbers of blood flow that can differ between the patients and controls. Is there anything different at all? And we found that yes, tinnitus does have an impact on the brain. The first difference we found was that globally, the patients showed reduced perfusion, that is reduced blood flow. And then we found that the regions which showed these declines were in the precuneus and the posterior cingulate cortex. This is nowhere near any of the auditory processing regions. They are part of what we call the default mode network, for instance. And the default mode network comes online when you are in quiet, when you're in rest, when you're not doing any attention challenging tasks. We have a lot of speculative hypotheses about it. Perhaps it has to do with how at rest you're more aware of your tinnitus than when it is very noisy around, you don't really hear your tinnitus. But again, this is the first study. The second interesting result we found was when we said, okay, let's consider clinically significant hearing loss. About 90% of those with tinnitus also have hearing loss. The flip side of this is that if you consider just the hearing loss population, roughly about 50% of them have tinnitus. We found that hearing loss alone also causes decreases in perfusion. Hearing loss within the tinnitus group also leads to it, and tinnitus by itself leads to it. So it's pointing to sort of this additive effect, perhaps in decreases in perfusion. The third thing we found was that severity of tinnitus has an impact. So the more bothersome your symptoms, the lower is the perfusion, lower is the blood flow. But the fact that you have changes in blood flow as a result of tinnitus is what we need to unpack, right? Is the decrease in blood flow allowing you to develop tinnitus, or is it the fact that you have tinnitus which has then resulted in this decrease in blood flow? So we cannot unpack that. This again points towards possible interventions. So with exercise, especially aerobic exercise, we actually improve these measures, right? There's greater blood flow to the brain, which presumably leads to better cognitive health. Will that allow individuals to habituate better, right? We're trying to now think about future studies where we can put these things together and actually see an improvement in blood flow, for instance, in individuals with tinnitus.